Governor, going back to the Wildfire Council, what is it that you're interested in seeing as far as how wildfires are fought?
So I think what I would say is, number one, we're going to need more people power and we're going to need more resources in terms of equipment. But I do think how we're fighting them has to be different. And so I go back to my experiences in Owasco, Sherman, Gillum County last summer, where it was basically wheatland farmers. And I think a large bulk of the fire was in unprotected lands, which means volunteers do that work. And because of the both the high temperature and the speed at which the fires traveled, and it, because it puts people's lives at risk and communities at risk, I don't think that having a volunteer-only fire force makes sense in certain parts of the state anymore. And so we obviously had structural firefighters assist with those attacks in Wasco, Sherman, and Gillum County. And I think they worked fairly collaboratively with the volunteer, primarily wheat and farmer community. But I do think we have to be more ahead of the game than that as we move into this fire season. So how we tack and tackle fire needs to be different. I go back to the Chetco Bar fire, which was a fire that was suppressed by the U.S. Forest Service but not eliminated in July of 2017. That grew to be, frankly, a nightmare. And so better alignment and coordination with our federal partners, U.S. Forest Service and BLM. But frankly, suppression, meaning not complete fire going out, is just not acceptable with the tinderbox situations that we have in regions around the state.
What about using fire, though, like corralling it to do the thinning that is required and that is so difficult for humans to actually go out?
Absolutely, and that's going to be a really difficult conversation for Oregonians, right, is a higher level of prescriptive burning, because when and how you do that really matters. And I think it is a very important tool. We removed fire from the landscape, particularly on federal public lands. We now have the challenge with climate change. These two are coming together. We have to use fire as part of the landscape. We have to use it in a way that will create healthier forests, but also will ensure the health and safety of our people in our communities.
Going back to last.